Good morning, I'm Clinton Griffiths. True price discovery has become a heated topic in Washington and in the cattle markets. The Biden administration recently launching a new effort to boost competition in the meat industry by dedicating $1 billion from the American Rescue Plan to expand independent processing. Strengthen rules under the Packers and Stockyards Act, along with new product of USA labeling rules. And as Farm Journal's Tyne Morgan reports, there are still ways true price discovery is happening for producers, and it starts with an opening bid.
Every Thursday at 1 o'clock, you'll find Byron Wheeler right here.
Our sellers for our feeder cattle, it'll be a 200-mile radius.
As the president and owner of Wheeler Livestock Auction, the business has changed since the family made its start 32 years ago.
We've added a lot better computer technology. We've got the Internet's the Facebook. We sell on live auction. People have the opportunity to bid online.
Wheeler says the feeder cattle buyers will travel from as far as 700 miles away.
The cattle market is a very viable tool for the cattlemen. I mean, we need them. We need them all over the country, not just here, but they need to be all over the country to get your fair price for your cattle.
John McGraw is one of those buyers who makes the 180-mile round trip to Wheeler Livestock Auction most weeks.
The market's gotten better. And because it's better, they want to sell them and take advantage of that.
And as a buyer, McGraw says it's the efficiency and reliability that keeps him coming back.
They tell you they're going to have something, they have it, they don't exaggerate, and they make it a point to take care of the buyer and the seller, which is, in my opinion, the best thing.
It's those same attributes that helps draw in sellers like Dale Underwood.
I just look for a place that's a fair market and honest.
Even in his 70s, Underwood has grown to appreciate the online auction aspect of the weekly sales.
There's times I don't want to come to the sale, and I can sit there at my kitchen table and watch it. He can't see me, but I can see him. But I like it. I think it's great, and I think that's the way to go. I think that was a good decision for the auction barn. I really do.
But for the Wheelers, the auction is the foundation of true price discovery in cattle prices today.
It's the only way to achieve the true price of what the cattle are worth is at auction. You have multiple buyers bidding on your cattle. At the end of the day, you know what the value of them is.
The debate over price has been a topic among cattle producers for years.
There's a lot of just simple supply and demand concepts that are interwoven in very complicated ways in this vertically connected industry. And you can't point to one thing and sort of hope it's going to solve it. It's not that simple.
Demand has been so strong that I think, in fact, that's been much of the driver as we've come out of COVID-19. Refilling those pipelines has been important to what's been the strength in retail prices.
But as consumers are faced with higher meat prices, cattle producers have not seen cattle prices climb at the same rate.
I'm not sure that the changes that we see here are by themselves gonna help producers either. We need to continue to be focused on price discovery and adequate price discovery. That's a very complex issue. I always say more cash traded cattle help with better price discovery, but doesn't equate to higher prices.
The whole topic about price discovery and transparency is complicated, right? We've moved away from having half the cattle spot negotiated for lots of reasons.
Wheeler says higher grain prices combined with climbing fuel and fertilizer costs continue to be a concern. He's optimistic about the new year.
The cattle market's on the climb. It looks like, I think 2022 is going to be a great year for the cattlemen.